scared. You're right, guys. This is Gameboy Luke here, your coach for the Bristol City Blazerkins, and here we are, week two, facing Leo and the coach of the Durham Druddigans. That's right, right? Okay, right. 6 foot hacks. I'm so scared because last week we played well. You know, we did so well, and I'm very happy with the performance we had last week. But I'm just a little bit salty that we got no luck with all the flinch hacks and stuff. You should definitely check out that battle, by the way. It was crazy. So we did lose our first week battle, but we're gonna bounce back. I'm determined to bounce back. The team is looking rather flames, if I am honest. I didn't get a lot of time to build the team, but I had a friend help me do it. So shout outs to Victor for helping me build this. But we are looking. Yo, he has the Registeel. Now, I had a funny feeling that he would bring Registeel. No, actually, to be honest with you, this team, I'm pretty sure I was like, yep. So Registeel, Clefable, Victini, Sigalith are the four Pokemon I had a funny feeling he would bring. Registeel actually is a bit of a pain in the butt. But we're bringing Talonflame, Sylveon, Lucario, Gyarados, Kyurem, and your boy Beanie, the Mew. Well, he's bringing Druddigan, Registeel, Clefable, Victini, Sigalith, and Blastoise. And Blastoise is obviously Mega Blastoise. So that's scary. Mega Blastoise is a force to be reckoned with. So let me mute this real quick. Let me just see. I want to make sure my microphone volume is good. But let me just do that. All right, let me see. We have 49 seconds. He's got his lead. I honestly think lead. It's either lead Victini or lead Clefable, right? I kind of want to lead off with Lucario because either of those leads I can pretty much just pop straight away. I could lead with Beanie and maybe try and go for Willows. The two Pokemon I don't want to burn though are kind of, well, the two Pokemon he's got I can't burn are Victini and Sigalith because Sigalith can Psycho Shift with Magic Guard and stuff. So I could lead with Kyurem because Kyurem takes a bite out of pretty much everyone there unless he was to lead off with Registeel. I think he's a lead off of Registeel. I'm going to just go with Forks because what I can do is probably U-turn everybody. I'm not sure how fast he is. Look at my damage calculator. Not gonna lie, kind of running into this battle like guns blazing, sort of like I've got my M60, I'm just running like shooting in the air, like I'm just not really thinking, or I haven't had the chance to think too much about it, so I'm nervous. He's gonna bring out his Blastoise first. What did I do? I brought out Forks. Okay, that's fine. This is Talonflame, right? And he's got a Blastoise. So this sounds stupid, but I don't want to make a dumb mistake. I don't want to sit here and be like, okay, I'm not gonna outspeed this Blastoise, but I clearly will. So I'm just gonna U-turn. I'm just gonna U-turn and get out. This thing's probably got Rapid Spin, so I didn't bother bringing rocks because if you look at his team, the only Pokemon that's really affected by rocks are Sigalith and Victini, and I didn't think that was really that necessary. So I didn't bother bringing a rocks user, but I do have Defog on my own Mew, so I have an option to get rid of rocks if I need to. But I'm just gonna U-turn him. He's probably going to Mega Evolve and just hit me with a Water Pulse or something. So my question is, if I go into young Sylveon to take this, because he doesn't get Flash Cannon, does he? Mega Blastoise doesn't get Flash Cannon. I'm gonna check that. So let's go to, he is Mega Blastoise, probably an offensive spinner. Does Blastoise get Flash Cannon? He might get Flash Cannon, because if he does, that's going to be scary. Doesn't get Flash Cannon. Yes, he does get Flash Cannon. Oh my goodness, is he going to make the read? I think I should just go into Mega Gyarados, because what can he do? He might have... I'm trying to read. Like the thing is with draft format, right, is I don't know what to expect, because he could run HP Electric, because he might be trying to read me, but he can learn Flash Cannon, right? That's so fucking scary. I think Azure's the safest play, to be honest. I honestly do. If I go to the damage calcs though, and I have Mega Gyarados, Mega Gyarados out. What can Mega Gyarados do? Mega Gyarados. I don't have a Mega Gyarados on here. Let's just go Mega Gyarados. Okay, hold on. If I go offensive Dragonair, it's like a Crunch Code deck 40. It's not gonna do much. So it puts me in an awkward situation there, and he can do like, he could Skull Burn me, maybe. Skull's a thing. I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna go to Azure, because I honestly feel like Leo... I know Leo's a really, really good battler. Leo is a really good battler, so I'm expecting, like, Flash Cannon. He actually just went for Skull. Okay. That's fucking lame. That's lame. Don't burn... It's gonna burn me. It's going to burn me. Oh, it didn't burn me. Okay, so he Skulled. Question. I was really scared he would have a flash cannon or something. So if I do this real quick. I honestly don't know what to do. This is so difficult because it can get Aura Sphere, it can get all these stupid moves. But I can't sit here and Mega Evolve against him. Oh my god, what do I do against fucking, what do I do against Blastoise, bro? And then I'm just gonna go, I'm gonna do another switch. So dumb. I'm gonna go into Sylveon. I played really well last week, and I don't know if it's gonna show in this week's battle. Because Leo, just fighting Leo is scary to me. I'm pretty sure we didn't get to battle last season as well, because he had things going on and we had to skip our battle, so I got the win by default. So I haven't battled Leo in such a long time. This Blastoise is hella scary. Blastoise is hella scary.
Yay! Go Melody!
My pretty Sylveon. He withdrew. Okay, cool. So I don't know what he was expecting right there. But I went into my Sylveon while he went into his tree. Okay, so with this, I almost want to expect him to go into Registeel. So I'm actually just going to Baton Pass, because I think he's going to be faster than me. I'll go for Baton Pass, because if you use Baton Pass, you switch after he switched. Right, and I know full well he does not want to take a Hyper Voice, so he's going to switch out. This is a revolving door of Pokemon right now. He's going to go into Registeel. Of course he would. So I'm going to go into your boy. Actually, I don't know who I'm going to go into right now. That's a good question. I think my counter for Registeel is, I'm pretty sure it's meant to be Forks, right? But this thing does get Thunder Wave, and I'm not sure if I want to get my thing Thunder Wave, because I know Flare Blitz won't actually kill this Pokemon. So what I'm going to do is bring out Beanie right now, and I'm going to do my best to get a Will-O-Wisp off, right? But he might switch. Do you think he'd switch? Or would he get his Stealth Rocks up right now? So I could go for a knockoff. Maybe a knockoff might be a bit more benefit. I'm going to go for a knockoff. Let's go for a knockoff, because I have a funny feeling he might switch. I don't know if he wants to get residual damage on this thing. So if he switches out, I can knock off an item potentially. But I don't think he'd want this thing to get burned, because I think Registeel is definitely a Pokemon that wants to hit physically. So having it burned, you know, probably Stealth Rocks, Thunder Wave, probably has Iron Head. Let me look at some standard sets of this guy. Because you'd be surprised at how many people just run standard sets. Oh, Stealth Rocks. Seismic Toss even. So Seismic Toss is an option as well. So, oh, he did stay in. So I go for knockoff. Is that Leftovers or Rocky Helmet or Lefties? Okay, so that's good. He's going to go for Stealth Rocks, which is cool. That's not a problem because I can defog those away right now, actually. Which I think I'm going to do because I think he's going to switch out. So I want to get rid of Rocks as soon as possible. He's going to stay in. Okay, so I'm going to defog. I'm going to reveal defog right now. Goodbye, Rocks. He used Toxic. Okay, so he's going for Toxic. It's not actually a problem because, you know, Synchronized obviously can't pass it on to him because he's Steel type. You know, unless I was to land it, that would have been great. But what we're going to do right now is I want to go for a Willow because I'm not sure if he knows what I want to do. I'm just going to go for the Willow right now. And what I can do at some point is go for Heal Bell with Sylveon because I do have a Cleric. So I don't have to worry too much about that. I do have an option to get rid of the Toxic Poison. But I'm interested to see what he switches into. So if I can get a Will-O-Wisp off on this thing now, that'd be great. But it's nice to know that he has Toxic. Because if he had Thunder Wave, that would be a little bit shitty. If he had Thunder Wave, that would be a bit shitty. He might run both. I don't think he would, but he might run both. But knowing he has Toxic is kind of useful because I don't have to worry about being slow or losing. You know, I don't like Thunder Wave. I don't like Paralysis. Paralysis is not fun. It's not fun, okay? He does stay in. I get the Will-O-Wisp off. I'll take that. I'll take that to the bank. And what is he going to hit me with now? He might just hit me with a Seismic Toss. He goes to Stealth Rock again. Getting those Stealth Rocks up now. Okay. As I do get the burn. So that's really good. Now, the only issue right now is that I have to defog to get these rocks away, giving him a free switch. Because I can't have rocks up with Gyarados and Talonflame around, right? So I'm going to go for defog again. Hopefully he switches out because I don't think he can do much to me at this point. But if he doesn't, then I'm going to defog and he's just going to get the Stealth Rocks back up. So I can switch into Talonflame, actually. And Talonflame should be able to take this guy out. Which will scare him enough. And then we can make reads from there because he might switch out. He might want to get rid of it, which is fine. So I could potentially Swords Dance. Because if I look at his team, you know, honestly, if I Swords Dance, I can Brave Bird everything. Talonflame would be a very, very good late game sweeper for this. He's gonna switch out. You see here, my custom set. If he's at plus two, dude. Yeah, defog, bro. There's evasiveness fell, and the stones disappeared. That's fine. Okay, so what we can do now, I wanted to predict they have flash cannon. I honestly think I might be over-predicting a little bit. So should we just go into Melody? I'm gonna go straight into Melody. Because what we can do is either Wish Pass or potentially what am I doing? Am I gonna go into potentially Heal Bell so we can get rid of the poison off Beanie. Beanie! Because Beanie does have Roost as well, so we can get HP recovery back on Beanie, which is really good. So his HP isn't too much of an issue right now. But we shall see what he does. I honestly think he might just go straight for the Dark Pulse. But if he had Flash Cannon, that would be bad. Okay, that would be so bad. I made that read. I called it out. He withdrew. Okay. And comes into Moonshine. So I think he predicted me to go into Gyarados there. So what I'm curious about is that we have the little Sylveon over here, right? What is Sylveon gonna do to a Fable? Not a lot. And Clefable could sit here and just Calm Mind. Which is what I wanna read. I really wanna read Calm Mind right now. But he could just go straight up for like a... This is an issue. I could Baton Pass. Am I slower than you? It's a speed tie if he's got no speed investments. I don't want to hit it, so I'm going to Baton Pass anyway. I wanted a Heal Bell, but he's got a Calm Mind. Okay, I thought he might. That's cool. I am slower than him, so I lost a speed tie, which is actually kind of what I wanted. Because I am free now to just go ahead and Baton Pass out. The safe switch. Get the safe switch right there. So now I've got to think of what I want to do with this thing. So he just increases special defense. We really don't have much in terms of physical, because he can learn Thunderbolt. This thing's gonna set up all over my face right now. Ideally, I wanted to save Lucario for shit later. If I get the nasty plot Lucario up, and this thing's at plus one special defense. Let me see. Special defense plus one. A flash cannon's gonna still gonna do about 45%. If I get a nasty plot up. Okay, so I think the best thing to do is switch into Voyance here. We're going to do my Lucario. He is Focus Sashed. He is Focus Sashed, so I'm just going to go for Nasty Plot. I have no reason not to. This thing usually runs Thunder Wave, though, so I have to be careful. He might very well paralyze me here. But like I said, I can go back into Thingy later on Heal Bell if I need to. But if I can get Nasty Plot off here, that'd be really, really good. Because I think with Nasty Plot, I might be just be able to take down this Registeel. Yard, are you cursed? I'm at plus two, right? Vacuum Wave is going to do like 45%, which I'm not sure he's in range for, but he has Toxic, so he can't really do much to me if he switches into it, so I can just go for a Nasty Plot. Again, get to plus six if I wanted to and just start destroying everything. If he withdraws, interesting. And he comes into Dingimon, the Druddigon. So, with me at plus two right now, right? With me at plus two, none of my attacks kill. This thing does get Sucker Punch, so I can't... I can Flash Cannon, and then I can Vacuum Wave. And I can get rid of this thing right now. And I think I kind of want to get rid of this thing right now. So, I'm gonna go ahead and hit Flash Cannon. See what he does here. Druddigon can get like stuff like Fire Punch and stuff like that, but I did set up, so I'm not sure if he wants to stay in. I don't run Aura Sphere because our stab move is Flash Cannon, and we need the priority Vacuum Wave because this is a special Lucario to help take down some of the Pokemon later on in the game. Victini is this Pokemon was built to defeat Victini. But honestly, if I can take down Druddigon now with it, I'll be very happy. I don't want to switch out a Pokemon right now at all because Druddigon will hit it like a fucking truck. Right, Druddigon has pretty good. Yeah, he's a base 120 attack. It's not, you don't want to just switch out. I could go into Gyarados, but then again, you know, he probably can learn Thunder Punch. And I don't want to mess around with that. So if I can hit with a flash cannon, that'll be wonderful. We are at plus two. So let's see what we can do here. And if he wants to sucker punch me the following time, I can vacuum wave and I'll out-prioritize him. Because we both have plus one, but I speed, outspeed naturally anyways. So there's no problem here. Because his base speed is 48. He's slow. Oh, he switched out again. So we get free flash cannon on something, dude. We went to Victini. Brilliant. Because that's actually what I built this Pokemon to defeat. So I'm going to hit him with a flash cannon. Not going to do a great deal, which is okay. Not a problem, actually. He doesn't realize I'm Focus Sash. So I'm actually going to be able to rinse this Victini. He's gone. He's actually gone. Unless he switches out. And tries to play, maybe he's trying to read me to switch out. But regardless, if he does switch out, I do get the free Dark Pulse on something. So I put him in a really good position. I'm really happy I Focus Sash this Lucario. I'm so happy. I can mess around with him here. I honestly want him to overpredict me and switch out. He will use Blue Flare. So he went straight for it. It's gonna hurt a lot. I hit the one hit point. Focus Sash pops. Do I get burned? I don't get burned. Oh, he has the berry! Wait, hold care. Wait. Fuck! Oh my god, vacuum wave. I don't know if it'll kill. Oh, it will kill. Wait, hold up. Hold up. Wait, hold up. Yes, boys. Goodbye, Victini. So like I said, this thing was built to take down Victini, and Victini's gone. That's a really big physical threat gone right there. Vacuum Wave just saved our booty. Okay, so now we have to deal with this Sigalith, right? Sigalith. What do you want to run, Sigalith? What do you want to run? You outspeed us naturally, so there's literally no point in me being here. So if I can pass a wish off to Lucario at some point, that would be wonderful. I think we can preserve Lucario right now. I could Dark Pulse this thing and probably kill it, but that's kind of risky. I think what I want to do is go into Melody. Melody seems like a good idea. I'm going to go into Melody, I think, right now, because we're especially defensive. I want to save Lucario right here, because I can Wish Pass onto him. I could... I'm recording. Thank you. Okay, so you psychic, that's fine. I'm gonna eat that. That's yummy. That's absolutely delicious. I would pick this for days, beef. But what I want to do right now is wish and then pass it on, ideally. So, what is he gonna do? He might go into Registeel, maybe. What we can do is wish, and then Baton Pass, which means. We get switch initiative if he's faster than me. He'll hit Sylveon instead. I'm so glad we got rid of Victini, because Victini is a force to be reckoned with. I'm actually very happy that we got rid of him. Lucario came through, and I'm surprised he let it go. I really am. Because, like, it's... I don't know if he would predict me to have Vacuum Wave, but... You know, it's crazy. I almost got rid of Vacuum Wave for Aurasphere for Registeel. But then I realized we have Talonflame, which can deal with Registeel. So I was like, fuck it, we'll put Dark Pulse on there. We need to get rid of Victini. And it pulled through. So... Look at that. That's crazy. Because if we can Wish Pass back to Lucario, we'll have a full HP Lucario, which isn't great. You know, Lucario is pretty frail as it is, but I'd rather have him with some HP than none. You know, special defense to defense is 70. It's nothing to be, you know, nothing like... You could probably laugh at that, to be fair. But we shall see. I'm just happy that Victini's gone. But I did burn Registeel, actually. Registeel is on his way out, so I could probably finish off Registeel with Lucario. If we type Registeel, right? Okay, so he's switching Swagalith, which is fine. If I go to Regirock, say he has the NU tank, and I'm at neutral attack. An Aura Sphere. Oh no, I have another Aura Sphere. Vacuum Wave does 35%. Okay, so I just used that. Now... Why did he bring this out with this guy? That makes me think he has Flash Cannon. I keep thinking he's got Flash Cannon. Because we've seen so far. We saw Scald, right? Okay, I'm going to test something. Mega Blastoise. I want to assume he's Offensive Spinner. And I really want to assume he's got Flash Cannon. I don't know why. It's calling out to me. Flash Cannon is pretty much gonna kill me. Oh, wait, no. Hold the fucking phone. Flash Cannon is only gonna... It's... Oh, that's Lucario. Hold on. Sylveon. Flash Cannon actually doesn't kill me. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna heal Bell. I'm gonna get this heal Bell out of the way. I'm gonna receive the wish. He's gonna scold me. Okay, that's fine. Do what you want. Burn me. You can even burn me, bro. It doesn't even bother me. Get the heal Bell off. A Bell chimed. Get the poison off of your boy Mew. And now we're gonna be back at full. We're now back at full. So I'm gonna wish again, because I have the option of baton passing or just hitting this thing with hyper voice. He can sit here and scold me all he wants, and he's still not getting the butt. I don't know why he's staying in, because if I hyper voice this thing, it's gonna do some chunky damage. So I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna hyper voice him. He might think I'm gonna baton pass now that I've got everyone healed up. But if I hyper voice and he switches into something like Drudigan, I will scream. I'm telling you, I will scream. I will scream. I will scream. Let us see. I feel like this is like an episode of like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. And it's like in between each move, the music from the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire plays like dun 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 dun. It's just in my head. That's what it is. Unless my heart's beating so fast, but. I'm pretty sure if I get high rolls, I can take down this Blastoise in 2 hits. It's guaranteed three hit KO, but with his HP, the way it looks right now, might be able to take it down. Maybe. Very, 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 very small a chance I'll do it. It says the max roll I can get is 42.9. If you put those two together, that's like 40, it's like 86%, which I'm not sure he's actually on, so it might be a three hit KO. But regardless, he's gonna withdraw. Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna hit you with a hyper voice regardless. He goes into Swagglyph actually, so how much is this gonna do? Bruh! That's some chunky damage. See, now my question is, does he want to sack this thing? I'm gonna wish. Because I'm slower than this thing. I could baton pass wish back into Lucario right now. If I wanted to. Because I'm slower, so I'll switch second. That's why we have baton pass. Because I understand, if before anyone comments, I understand that wish, you don't need to baton pass. Bruno. This is Regigigas. Which is perfect, actually. That's perfect. Yo, that's perfect. I wished. Okay, he's taking burn damage. Now my question is he going to attack me? Because I want a baton pass, right? I'm gonna baton pass. I think I'm slower. No, I'm faster. No, I should be faster. Reggie's still slow as shit. What am I talking about? I get a free baton pass into someone. I want to predict he's gonna go for toxic. He's mind games right now. I think it's got to the point where he's like, is he going to baton pass the wish, or is he wishing to keep it on himself? Because Jesus Christ, Sylveon, you do damage even when you're on a bulky set. Like, I have 4 EVs in special attack. That's crazy. That's absolutely ridiculous. I think at this point we can confirm that Blastoise does not have Flash Cannon, though, because he would have used it by now for sure. Okay. It's fine. This is fine. This is absolutely fine. So I use Baton Pass because I'm faster, of course. Now I am on 1 hit point. Do I want to predict he's going for Toxic? Is that a cheeky read? I think it is. But actually at this point, Forks can just hit this thing. I'm gonna go into Forks. I honestly think he's gonna go for Toxic. And I should have gone into Lucario. But we're gonna go into Forks. He goes for Stealth Rock. Okay, so I made a good read right there, because if I went into Lucario, he would have been dead. He would have been gone. He gets some burn damage. Now, my question is, because if I have my Talonflame out, if I go for a Swords Dance, will Brave Bird kill the Blastoise? It will. So I think I want to go for Swords Dance right here. I'm going to go for it. So I would kill this Reggie Steel right here. So we can't stay in. I can get the read. And then either he'll switch into his Clefable, which could... Does Clefable get unaware? I don't remember if Clefable gets unaware or not. I don't remember what she gets. She doesn't. She gets Magic Guard and... No, she does get unaware. Yes, a hidden ability. So if I do get the Swords Dance up, he could probably switch into Clefable and then it's not even a thing. But if I go to Clefable, Carmine, Magic Guard, he might be unaware. Brave Bird would do... Brave Bird would almost... He has a chance to kill, but if he has unaware, it's going to do it half his health, so... Who knows? Who knows what he'll do here? I get priority Brave Bird, so that kills... If I Swords Dance now, that kills Garrett, that kills... Blastoise, that kills... Sigalith. Drudigan, it's going to do a chunky, mean-ass... Nice and... Almost kill it. Jesus Christ. I go for Swords Dance. Alright, now this is where it matters right now. I don't know if I want to trust this Brave Bird right here. This Brave Bird apparently is going to do... Wait, what? I don't think he's in range. I don't know if I want to risk it because he'll kill me. He will kill me. Wait, Scald doesn't kill me. No, that's Mega... I'm on the wrong one. Mega Blastoise. Offensive Spinner. At level 50. A Scald will kill me. A Brave Bird might kill. Oh my god, I don't know if I'll risk it. That's not worth it. It's not worth it. I got the bulk. I got the power up. U-turn will do like 37%. I think that's good. I think that's good enough, if I'm honest. I think I'm just going to go for U-turn right here. I don't want to risk it. I'm too scared. He withdrew. Sick. Okay. I should have stayed in. I should have gone for Brave Bird, but he went into Damien, the Drudigan. I should have Brave Birded. It would have killed. I'm going to go for U-turn. I still have plus two U-turn right there. Rough skin. Okay. What I need to do is I need to go into Mew and I need to get Defog back up. I need to get rid of those rocks because those rocks are going to be a pain in the ass. Especially with Forks. I actually really think I should have gone for Brave Bird. I should have gone for my gut, dude. Should have gone for it. I see what Drudigan can do to my Mew. Because Mew's physically defensive as well. Let me see here. So I'm actually pretty good. Outrage is going to do like 50% to me. I should live that. Let's go for Roost. Actually, no, should I Will-O-Wisp him? I think a Will-O-Wisp would be safest move right now. No, let's go for Roost. I'm going to get my health back up because I'm going to be faster than him anyways. So I'm going to Roost. So I can get my HP back to full. I really wish I'd just fucking hit the big red button, dude, and just gone BAM! Because it would have killed him! Wasn't sure if it was going to kill his Blastoise. I honestly think... I should have gone with it. I didn't want to risk losing it. Because it would have killed him if otherwise. And I honestly think, once I get rid of Registeel... What's this? This is you again. Once I get rid of Registeel... He's going to try and set up again. This thing sets up, we're screwed. We're actually screwed. And I think my actual check to this thing is Lucario. This is sticky. This is really sticky. I need to defog to get rid of rocks for Lucario to come back in later. And he's my check. I could go into Kyurem. Because Kyurem does have Flash Cannon. Yes, he does. The only thing is my Choice Scarf. And if I go to the Fable, Flash Cannon is going to do like half his health. But if he has plus one Spadef, and he kills me with Moonblast. No, he doesn't. He doesn't kill me with Moonblast. I need to get these rocks out. I need to get rid of these rocks. I am going to get rid of these rocks. I think I made the decision to do that. I'm gonna get rid of rocks. This is so risky because this Clefable could change the whole game. So I clear the rocks. He's going to Carmine. So I've got rid of the rocks now. If it's a plus two special defense, One special attack doesn't kill me still. Two special attack guaranteed kills. This is trouble. This is really big trouble right now. Talonflame. If I want a Brave Bird, I can't spell Talon. If I want a Brave Bird, it's going to do about 50%. So I honestly need to come in with Kyurem. Kyurem's not really, you know, Kyurem hits so hard. I honestly think I need to just bring him out and just do what he can do right now. Do as much chip damage as possible and I can get switch initiative to someone else. So we bring out the big gun. This big boy Kyurem. Applying some pressure. He's gonna calm mind again. He thunderbolted! That's interesting. Oh, he got the paralysis. That's not funny. That's really shit, actually. That's actually really... That's fucking lame. I can't stay in. I can't risk that. That's so lame. That's a 1 in 10 chance. That's so lame. You know, when he hit me with a thunderbolt, it's always there in the back of your mind. I instantly jinxed myself because I'm sat here thinking, he's gonna paralyze me. He's going to paralyze me. Look what he did. Look what he did. He done did it. I'm interested to see what his response to paralyzing me is going to be, though. Is he going to straight up hit me with a Moonblast? Is he going to predict me to switch out? What's your plan, bro? What are you going to do? Choice Scarf Kyurem being paralyzed is a cripple. It's not good. It cripples my team completely. What am I talking about? It doesn't cripple my team completely. It cripples Kyurem completely. My team's okay without Kyurem, but I wish I had Weezing, because a clear smog would be so good right now. But he has Thunderbolt. So we know Clefable now has... He has to have Moonblast, Calm Mind, and Thunderbolt. The next move I want to predict he has is Soft Boiled. So he has Recovery. Switch out. Go back to Melody. Is he gonna Calm Mind again? He Moonblast. I had a funny feeling. I had a funny feeling he had Moonblast. That's not gonna do too much to me because I'm a freaking tank. I do lose Spidef. Oh, it's lose. That's fine. I'm not attacking with Sylvie anyways. I completely forgot that. I thought it was Spidef. It's like psychic. That's what I thought it was, like psychic. I'm going to heal Bell because that's absolutely ridiculous. I'm going to get rid of that stupid paralysis right now. He's going to Calm Mind. Ah, this is not good. This is not good. So he has Thunderbolt for Talonflame. That's what it's for. If he Moonblasts at plus 2, it's only going to do half to your boy. Is it faster than me? He is faster than me. Is he got speed investments? He must have speed investments. Let me wish. This is so lame. If I had at least got a bit of damage off in this, that'd be great. I think if he gets Clefable at like plus 6, we lose. Pretty much lose, because he's just Calm Minding at this point, and I can't do anything about it. I literally can't do anything about it. Can't do it. This is so shit. I don't know what to do. Mega Gyarados can punch a hole because it's got Waterfall. But I don't want to bring him out first. I'm gonna just straight up Baton Pass into. Oh my god! I just almost hard switched. I'm gonna straight up Baton Pass into Talonflame, I think. He goes for Moonblast, that's fine, I'm gonna eat this. I should still eat this. Good shit, Melody. Let's get out of here. So I'm gonna Baton Pass, right? Now I need to figure out who's the best Pokemon to go into right now. Gyarados can do 50% and might have the chance to flinch. Talonflame is going to do 50% with Brave Bird. So I could easily... I could waterfall first with Gyarados, because Gyarados is... I don't really think Gyarados is necessary for... I'm going to go into Gyarados, I think. I want to go into Gyarados, and then I want to waterfall it. And then afterwards, I can follow up with... Fucking hell, dude. If I can get some flinch. I got flinched out of my ass last time. Let's hope that I can do it back. Get the Intimidate. It's not going to do anything. Okay, so my question is, if he Thunderbolts, is he plus three now? Is he plus three now? Because if he Thunderbolts me at plus three, can I live it? That's my question. I do live it. So I could go for a D-Dance first. Because Mold Breaker ignores Unburden. So... Mold Breaker ignores Burden. I want a Mega and Dragon Dance. I think I can survive it. I'm gonna do it. I'm risking it. Come on, Luke. Please, 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 please. Oh, what if he goes for... Oh, no, I just thought if he goes for Moonblast, we're dead. I thought he would go for... Fuck. He just used Moonblast, didn't he? Oh, I didn't think about that. Oh, I didn't think about that. Shit, it's after I pushed the button I thought about that. Fuck me. That's dead. Shit. Shit. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. Shit. I should have gone for Waterfall. Shit. Okay. We have to put efforts together now. I'm so stupid. I hate myself. I actually hate myself so much. Let me just flash cannon. I'm just gonna flash cannon and see much damage Lucario can. It's not gonna be anything. It really isn't. If I can get a crit, that'd be fantastic. It's not gonna happen, but we'll see what happens. Can I be blessed? He got a 1 in 10 chance to paralyze me, right? They're not saying it necessarily affected the game too much, but if he can get that, then can I possibly get a crit with my flash cannon? It doesn't even have to kill. It doesn't even have to kill. Okay, that's not enough. Not enough damage at all. Moonblast's gonna hit me now. Okay. Does he have lefties? He has lefties, okay. Thinking. I need to whittle this thing down. So, I have to go... I think he's one at this point, because I'm stupid. But if I go into... Kyurem, right? And I Flash Cannon... If I Flash Cannon it... I'm not saying it will. We might just be in range. We might just be in range to kill it with Brave Bird. Maybe. Come on, Kyurem. Deal some damage. Okay, that's fine. That's not actually enough percent. However, if we bring in Talonflame and now we Brave Bird it, we might be able to put it in range for someone else to take care of it. It's a very, very big long shot. I basically screwed up. That one move screwed me up because I should have just gone for Waterfall. I got a bit greedy. I completely forgot Gyarados is Dark type when he Mega Evolves, and I screwed up. I screwed up. So let's go for Brave Bird. There's no point trying to do any U-turn shenanigans because he resists it. You know, I could U-turn switch, then Brave Bird, but he'll get his HP back anyways. So let's just hit him with a Brave Bird. Let's see if we can't do enough damage to wipe him out. I don't think we can, and I think we just lost our second match due to a silly, silly mistake. You live and you learn, though. This was a very... I think this... Aside from the score, it was definitely a very close match, for sure. I am a little bit upset with that, but... I was on tilt. I'm on a little bit on tilt today, so... I think I can excuse one misplay. One big misplay at that, but it's no biggie. It's no biggie. What is he thinking about? Is he like, do I moonblast it? You just push the red button, dude. You're already there. Oh my god, we got a crit!
That mattered. That mattered.
Forks, I fucking love you, Forks. Oh, you don't understand, Forks. Oh my goodness, we're back in this game, boys. Forks, what are you doing? Forks.
I don't believe that just happened, Forks.
Forks. Forks! That wasn't gonna kill. Oh my god, we got the crit. Are you serious? Are you serious? He is mad. I am cool. He is mad, dude. Yo, what's up, Drudigan, bro? Oh my god. I'm sweating. My paws. Okay. Question. Does Drudigan get poison jab? I want to say yes. Yes, he gets Sludge Bomb and he gets Poison Tail. Gunk Shot. So I think he's going to read me to switch into Sylveon here, because that's really, really obvious if he's going for Outrage or anything. Let's go into Mew and let's get a Willow off. If I can burn this thing, that'd be sick. As he just pulls out, yeah, he pulls out Gunk Shot. Okay, it's fine. I can eat that. I should be able to eat. Yeah, I'm impish, bro. I'm fucking impish. Okay. Let's Will-O-Wisp. If we burn this bitch, he's useless. I think he's stalling time because we're coming to the 20-minute mark. So it makes sense for him to want to choose his moves really slowly because he's stalling out. If we can knock one more Pokemon out though, it becomes a draw and then he has to kill me. He has to take down one of my mons. So he's obviously just going to take his time, do what he needs to stall out this game. Because he's done it before. I'm pretty sure he did it last season. So, which is kind of a crappy way to go about it, if I'm honest. He could be that guy. He could exhaust every single time. Because I think you get 90 seconds to choose your move. So with that bearing in mind, we have about eight turns left. Which might not be enough time for me to kill another Pokemon. And we end up drawing. I honestly think that stalling out the clock should be banned, though. It seems like, because what would you decide to do here? Okay, he's gonna switch out. He's probably gone into Sigilyph. He didn't. He went into. Okay, so this thing's probably got Dark Pulse. So I'm just gonna Will-O-Wisp you. I'm gonna get that burn. That's fine. Okay, so if I go Sylveon. Sylveon, my custom set Sylveon. We go Mega Blastoise. Offensive Spinner. Sylveon, he's only doing like 28%, so I can get a Wish and Baton Pass if I need to. So I'm gonna go into Melody. Let me just do this real quick. I'm a very low HP, so this is risky. This is very risky. He just goes for the Scald. If I don't get burned again, we may have a chance. Because that does... Okay, there's the burn. That's fine. That's you know, it's fair. I honestly completely agree with that. If I Hyper Voice, I can potentially Brave Bird the rest of his team. So if I go to Talonflame, right? Talonflame. My custom set Talonflame does 48%. So if I Hyper Voice this thing... If I Hyper Voice this thing like this... He's faster than me! Oh shit. Oh shit, he's faster than me. He's faster than me. Okay, that's fine. Or not. It's not actually fine. I lied. I'm a big fat liar. Okay, so Mew. Mew's only attacking move, I'm pretty sure, is only knockoff. So this is really bad. I have to stall him out. I'm faster than this thing. I have to stall him out so I can knock off. Maybe I can just keep roosting. Because as soon as I get, because all I need to do is get him down to a point where I can kill him, right? Because I can Brave Bird. I can Brave Bird Sigalith. I can Brave Bird Sigalith. I can Flare Blitz Registeel. Oh, yo, I'm on a half health. I might die to recoil, actually. I do have Roost, but I don't know when I'd get the opportunity to use it. What does Drodigan run? That covers that option. He has Dark Pulse. I have the Ocker Berry. He has Ocker. Colbert Berry, sorry. So he gets the burn. You see the burn right there. So I'm just going to Roost. I don't know if I can take this, to be honest. I really don't. Dark Pulse is like 43%, actually, so I might heal more than he does damage to. Oh, wait, no, I have the Ocker Berry still holding. Where's his burn? Okay, so one more burn, and he's dead. Okay, my question is, Talonflame. Yeah, Dark Pulse kills him. So I was at almost full. It did 170, 160 damage. Unless I get a crit. Knockoff might kill from this range. I'm gonna give it a shot. Okay, Blastoise is down. Hold the phone. That's more HP for Talonflame. All this Pokemon, I'm pretty sure I'm fat. No, I'm not faster against Sigalith. I am not faster than Sigalith. What does Sigalith run? Psystock's going to do like 77% to Talonflame, unfortunately. Okay, think. Unfortunately, I don't think Mew. Mew's meant to be a bulky Mew, so it doesn't have investments in speed. However, we do outspeed it base stats-wise, so if he doesn't have any investments in his speed as well, then we might be able to get a Roost off. If I can get a Roost off, I can knock him off. I might just knock him off at the beginning, because that'll kill him. Because he's like half health. Yeah, knockoff does like 70%, so why roost? Why risk it? I could just knock him off straight away and then I can let... You came out. Why did you come out? You gonna toxic me? I don't understand. I can roost now. Oh, he's getting rocks up! Okay, that's fine. I can just defog them away. Yo, hello. Toxic me. Do it, bro. Fucking do it. Okay. So he poisoned me. I can't get rid of it. That's fine. I'm at fucking 130 HP. That's great. So now, what we do is we go into Talonflame. Come into Talonflame. Oh my god, this game. This game. I've got to remember we have Gale Wings Roost as well, actually. That's a good point. So if I need to... I can do that. I can do this. This is possible. I'm going to switch out. Because he's burned. His attack is halved. What is he gonna have to dick me on? Stealth Rocks. Look, he just brought a fucking Stealth. Too late! It's too late! This Registeel, dude. He's burned, okay? I'm just out of curiosity. Just out of curiosity, if he is burned, where is burn? Where the fuck is burn on here? Current HP. Let's just put minus two attack. I can't be bothered. If he taught this thing rock slide, at minus two, it does 49%. I'm gonna fucking roost. I'm roosting. I'm actually gonna. I don't have roost. I have sword stance. Duh. Jesus Christ. I could. I think I should flare blitz. I think I should flare blitz. Do I flare blitz? I think I should. Oh, fuck me. Fuck me. Fuck me. Flare blitz hits everything. I'm gonna flare blitz. He withdrew. He's going into Drudigan. Raybud is 60%. Oh my god, this is fucking close. Brave Bird can potentially kill from this. Brave Bird can potentially kill from this. It will kill myself. I'm just gonna go for, oh, what if he switches out? I'm gonna go for Brave Bird. I should have Swords Dance. I actually wish I had Swords Dance. I was so tempted to, because I didn't think he had a move for me. If I Swords Dance, we could have Brave Bird the rest of his team. Brave Bird might kill. If it kills him, it kills me. That's fine. We have a Mew with 120 hit points. And then we have to deal with Sigalith, which I can knock off and kill. But we can continue roosting ourselves up. Okay. Go for Brave Bird. Please kill it. Not quite enough. Get the recoil damage, I die. I don't think we have enough to take him down. I don't think knockoff's gonna be enough to take him down, actually. Use Dragon Tail. Okay. I see you. Okay, so let's go to Mew. Can Beanie pull through for us? Can Beanie pull through? Can he take down these last three Pokemon? Is it possible? Okay, so Mew. I actually want to figure out. Wait. Knock off will kill. No, he's got Sucker Punch. Oh my god, he got Sucker Punch. No, he lived! Oh! He lived on one hit point. He lived on one. That's the game. That is such a shame. That is such a shame. Mew could have.
I'm going to stall this game out. I do not care. Let's go, Roost. Oh my god, that's so dumb.
It does nothing! Oh my god, this is so dumb. Toxic is gonna get ridiculous, okay? That's the one thing I'm scared about. Toxic is gonna get stupid at some point. It's gonna get to the point where I can't anymore. I need to work this out of my head. So Toxic right now is doing about 40 hit points. After knockoff, I think... I want to roost one more time. I can't figure out how much Toxic does. What is Toxic? Does it just keep going until you get killed? I honestly don't know. I avoided it. Oh my god, I avoided it. That's free damage. Okay, Toxic. Okay, so that did 50 odd damage to me. Let me knock you off and get you out of here now. Because that's the best we're going to get right there. I need the condition. Is it TMC engine so far? Rough skin, okay, that's fine. Toxic badly poisons, okay. Generation 2, there is a stuff. Which is outside battle. Okay, so we have this little guy. We have this dude. So, if I just keep roosting, he dies to burn, right? You can't hit me with shit. That's not gonna do anything. I'm impish. You're burned. It's not doing a single bit of damage to me. I think poison's hit the point where it's not... Okay, hold on. I'm gonna roost. I'm just gonna keep roosting, because I have this residual damage. I actually want him to live this burn. I actually want him to stay alive so I can get another roost off, so I'm like pretty much almost, you know, the best I can be when it comes to being poisoned. Which he didn't do, so I'm at 81. I'm at 81 hit...
He survived on 4 hit points and took down the last 3 team members. That's the most insane battle I've ever. GG. The best battle I've ever had in my entire. What? Mew survives with 4 hit points, badly poisoned, and still takes down 3 more Pokemon. When do you see that? I can't believe it. I'm shaking. We did it. We actually just did that. Bro, I told you the Bristol City Blaze Kids would bounce back. Oh my god, if you enjoyed that battle, please do click that like button down below. It's super awesome for you. Oh my god. Check out Leo's perspective in the link in the description below. I know I will. I can't contain myself right now. I can't believe you just did that. Yo, freaking Beanie is the team. I can't believe we just did that. I can't. Bristol City Blaziken's, everybody. Oh my god, winning our second game. Yes!